Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for July the 14th of 2020, well, it is titled Comet NEOWISE over Stonehenge. So what do we see here? Well, as we've looked at a number of times, this is Comet NEOWISE, prominently visible in the sky right now, and actually visible with the naked eye. So if you look at the instructions here in the explanation down below, it would tell you how to see this, and you want to look low to the horizon right after sunset now. So you have a chance to be able to see this, look towards the horizon, towards the northwest, and as the sky darkens, you should be able to see a fuzzy patch in the sky stretching up diagonally, and that would be Comet NEOWISE. And a comet is essentially a ball of ice, which is really much smaller than pictured here. The nucleus of a comet, the actual part of a comet, can only be a couple miles across. But when it comes close to the sun, it gets heated up and that material gets vaporized. And because the comet has very low gravity, it gets pushed back. So we see it pushed back into the great tails of the comet. So the nucleus of the comet is not what we're seeing here. We're seeing kind of a mini atmosphere around the head of the comet. And then some of that being pushed back up into the distance here. So a chance to be able to see that, if you've never had a chance to be able to see a comet, it would be a much better view with binoculars. You could see it far better as you'll be able to see more of the detail of it, but can even be seen over the next few nights with the naked eye. So a great chance to be able to take a look at a comet here. Now, here we see the comet over another prominent astronomical feature, and that is Stonehenge. Stonehenge, here, as we see, is a great stone circle, which is believed to be, in many ways, an ancient calendar, a way of being able to predict these seasons. So, if you look at, from the center of Stonehenge and you look out over the distance, you would be able to see the sun rise on the first day of summer, and it would rise directly over another stone off in the distance. So it is believed that ancient peoples thousands of years ago put this together as a way of marking the patterns in the sky. Now, some patterns were regular, like the sun and the moon go through very specific patterns, as do the planets, that we can follow them and make predictions as to what they'll do over the years and the decades. Comets, of course, were very different. They were very unpredictable until very recently. We did not understand in ancient times what a comet was, except that it was something new appearing in the sky, which is usually a sign of disaster, that something was changing in the heavens. And it wasn't until Edmund Halley made a prediction of a comet that he observed its orbit and found that it was the same comet, that multiple apparitions of the same comet had occurred, and that we were then able to predict that some comets would be able to return to Earth. For Comet NEOWISE, that is not very often. It will not return once it leaves here. It will not return for thousands of years. So if you get a chance, get out and try to see if you can catch a glimpse of this comet. So that was our picture of the day for July the 14th of 2020. It was titled Comet NEOWISE over Stonehenge. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be NEOWISE night. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.